So in this lecture, I'm going to talk about this thermodynamical processes. Suppose we are considering a thermodynamical system, and let us assume that it is produced with some amount of heat energy. As a result, what takes place is change of state takes place. But this change of state takes place can be brought under many processes. Those are called as thermodynamical process. If the temperature is fixed, then the process what is called as isothermal process. But the process should be carried out in a slow manner, because we can apply this equation of state only for thermodynamical equilibrium. So through the stages, as the system goes from the initial state to a final state, the process should be carried in a very slow way. That slow way process is what is called as quasi-static process. So the various processes associated with the thermodynamical system, the first one is called as an isothermal process. Here, pressure and volume of the given mass of a gas varies while the temperature has been fixed as a constant. Since change of internal energy depends upon temperature, there won't be any change because the temperature remains constant. Therefore, the first law of thermodynamics can be written as Q equal to W. And the equation of ideal gas equation, PV equal to mu RT. Since T is a constant, we can write PV is a constant. This is an equation that represents this isothermal process. So I can write P is inversely proportional to V. Once two quantities are inversely proportional to each other, while we are drawing a curve between them, what we get is what is naturally it is what is called as hyperbola. So the variation of pressure with the volume in isothermal process is a hyperbola. Now let me draw an isotherm, that is the graph representing pressure and volume, as I have shown here. So the isothermal process is represented by this way. Let us assume that the change between two volumes, one is of V1 as well as V2. So as to find out the amount of work done, how much is the area covered by this curve? So the area under the curve that gives the amount of work done, mathematically it is represented as W equal to integral of V1 to V2 P into dV. From gas equation we can write P equal to mu into R into T by V. So once we make a substitution, we have integral of dV by V. Integral of dV by V gives you ln of V. Since the integration has been carried within the limit of V1 to V2, we can write ln V2 by V1. The remaining things are constant. Therefore, the amount of work done is given by mu into R into T ln of V2 by V1. Suppose I have carried the experiment to have a greater value in the final state than the initial state. As per this equation, the amount of work done becomes positive. So once the amount of work done is positive, work is done by the system. Suppose the process has been carried in such a way that V1 is greater than V2, then the amount of work done is negative. So these are the conventions that have been used in thermodynamics. As a matter of illustration, I have shown a curve representing this temperature with respect to volume. Here, the temperature is a constant. As the process has been carried from A to B at constant temperature with change of volume, the volume has been changed from V0 to 2V0, but the temperature remains the same. So I need to find out the amount of work done under the curve. So the formula is W equal to mu into R into T, then log of 2V0 by V0. As a result, I get ln 2. So W equal to mu RT, ln 2, nature logarithm is converted into the base 10 by a factor 2.303 into the value of log 10 is 0.3010. Hence, I can find out the amount of work done for the given system. Now, I know this P1 V1 equal to P2 V2 because the temperature remains constant. Therefore, V2 by V1 can be represented as V1 by P1 by P2. Therefore, W equal to mu into R into T into ln of P1 by P2. Once the change of pressure is given, we can find out the amount of work done by using this formula. So I have shown an isotherm that has two different isothermal process at two different temperature, one is of T1 and T2. Since I want to find out whether T1 is greater or T2 is greater, so as to find out this, let me draw a line. So the pressure is at constant. I have fixed the pressure to be a constant. Now, as I draw a line, V1 is the volume corresponds to the temperature T1, and V2 is the volume corresponding to the temperature T2. Now, keeping the pressure of the gas at constant volume, I can identify this point to have a volume of V1. And this point have a volume of V2. So, from the graph, I can identify this V2 is greater than V1, therefore T2 is greater than T1. So this is the way we can find out which quantity is greater, whether T1 and T2. So the next thermodynamical process, what is called as adiabatic process. So unlike isothermal process, here no heat is allowed to enter the system. Therefore, that is Q equal to 0. So, since no heat is allowed to enter into the system, the entire work has to be done at the cost of this internal energy. That is, the internal energy possessed by the molecules should do the amount of work done. As a result, the internal energy decreases. Since internal energy is a function of temperature, once internal energy decreases, the temperature also decreases. So, in an isothermal process, work has been done by at the cost of this internal energy, therefore the temperature decreases. One of the equations that represents an adiabatic process is given by PV raised to gamma is a constant. So, let me calculate how much is the amount of work done during an adiabatic process. The general expression for the amount of work done is given by W equal to integral of P into dV. In the place of P, I can substitute a constant divided by V raised to gamma. After making some simple mathematical manipulation, I can land it over this expression W equal to R into gamma minus 1 into T1 minus T2, where T1 is the initial temperature of the system and T2 is the final temperature of the system. Suppose I am providing with the system of initial pressure P0 and initial volume V. Let us assume that the volume of the system has been reduced to V by A by V. So I can find out this pressure P2 using this equation. PV raised to gamma is a constant. So I can write P1 V. Since we know PV raised to gamma is a constant, we can write P1 V1 raised to gamma equal to P2 V2 raised to gamma, which can be modified as P2 equal to P1 into V1 by V2 raised to gamma. So in the place of V2, I need to place this V by A. As a result, I can find out this P2. So in my next illustration, I have considered 1 mole of a gas. It is subject to a condition. P is inversely proportional to square root of the volume of the gas. So I need to find out this gamma. This is my problem. So the equation given relate temperature and volume. So we have an equation relating temperature and volume in adiabatic process as T into V raised to gamma minus 1 is a constant. From the given condition, T is proportional to 1 by square root of V. I can change that as T into V raised to gamma, V raised to half is a constant. So comparing these two equations, I can recognize gamma minus 1 is half, therefore gamma equal to 3 by 2. So in my next illustration, I am given with the situation P is proportional to cube of temperature. I am asked to find out this gamma. So this is a relation relating pressure and temperature. Therefore, there is a relation in adiabatic process as P into P raised to 1 minus gamma into T raised to gamma is a constant. So this equation can be modified as P into V T raised to gamma divided by 1 minus gamma is a constant. The given equation is P is directly proportional to T cube, which can be modified as P into T raised to minus T is the constant. So from these two equations, we can recognize this gamma by 1 minus gamma equal to minus 3. Multiplying UU, gamma equal to minus 3 plus 3 gamma. From this, we can determine this gamma as 3 by 2. This is about adiabatic process. Next, I am going to talk about this isobaric process. It is a process in which the pressure is a constant. Therefore, the volume is directly proportional to temperature. So the expression for the amount of work done is given by W equal to P into del V. Since del V is the change in volume, P is the pressure, we can change this P into del V as mu into R into del T using this gas equation, ideal gas equation. Therefore, the amount of work done can be written as W equal to mu into R into del T. So, W equal to mu into R into delta T. Once you know the change in temperature, you can find out this amount of work done. So these things can be illustrated using a simple graph by me. Here I am taking this temperature along the x-axis and the pressure along the y-axis. So a system is taken from A to B and then from B to C. I want to find. So I have drawn a curve representing this pressure with temperature. Here a system of gas is taken from A to B, then from B to C. I need to find how much is the amount of work done as the system has been carried from A to C. First, let us consider the work done from A to B. So it has been taken place at constant temperature. Therefore, I can identify this as an isothermal process. But the pressure, initial pressure is 1 atmospheric pressure and the final pressure is 2 atmospheric pressure. Since the work done is with respect to the change in pressure, the corresponding equation can be written as W1 equal to mu into R into T, ln of P1 by P2. Here, the initial pressure is 1 atmospheric pressure, the final pressure is 2 atmospheric pressure. So, the resultant equation W1 equal to mu into R into capital T, ln 1 by 2. In the second case, as I do some work from B to C, I can see the process is what is called as isobaric process because the pressure is at constant. So under that condition, I can make use of this formula W2 equal to mu into R into delta T because this is an equation that representing an isobaric process. So mu into R here, delta T, the change in temperature. So the initial temperature is 200, the final temperature is 400. Therefore, 400 minus 200 gives me W2. The total amount of work done can be calculated by W equal to W1 plus W2. So, I wish to correlate these three processes, isobaric, isothermal and adiabatic, using a curve that represents the variation of pressure with volume. The first curve, that is of an isobaric process, here the pressure remains constant. Then the process what is called as an isothermal process. Normally the adiabatic process is steeper than this isothermal process. It's a very important concept. Now I have to compare where in which process the amount of work done is more. For that I have to see where there is more amount of work done. So this is an isobaric process. So more area is under this isobaric process. Therefore the amount of work done in isothermal process is greater. So, let us go for this isothermal. As compared with the isobaric, it covers lesser area. Lesser area is under the curve, so the amount of work done is lesser. In the case of adiabatic process, it covers the least area, therefore the amount of work done is least. This is the way we have to find out the amount of work done during various processes using graphical analysis. Then now the next question is, in which process the change of internal energy is more, in which process the change in internal energy less. For that, let us consider this isothermal process. The isothermal process, the temperature remains constant. Therefore, there is no change in internal energy. The change in internal energy is zero. But in the case of isobaric process, more amount of work has been done. More amount of work has been done means more amount of volume has changed. As a result, more amount of temperature has changed. So more amount of work leads to more amount of change in volume. That leads to more amount of change in temperature. Therefore, in the case of an isobaric process, the change in internal energy is more. In the case of adiabatic process, the gas has to do the work by the decrease in internal energy. Therefore, the change in internal energy is the greatest in isobaric process, and change in internal energy is lesser in adiabatic process. The next process is what is called as isochoric process. Here the volume is constant. Therefore, we can write the pressure is directly proportional to the temperature. Since volume is a constant, change in volume is zero. Therefore, the amount of work done is zero. So it's a very important thing. Here, I have made an illustration for isobaric process. So in this illustration, I have shown the variation of pressure with volume by a curve. Here, the system has been taken from initial pressure P1 to the final pressure P2 at constant volume, that is V1. So as a result, there is no change in volume, del V equal to 0. Since work done equal to P into del V, the amount of work done is also 0. So the next process what is called a cyclic process. As the process ends, where does it start? There is no change in internal energy. Even though there is a sequence of changes has been takes place, there is no change in internal energy. So the change in internal energy is zero. Therefore, we can write Q equal to W from first law of thermodynamics. Therefore, definitely, we have separate some amount of heat, the amount of work done is non-zero. As we illustrate this cyclic process, I have shown a variation of pressure with volume using a, since some amount of heat is given to the system, definitely there will be some amount of work done. Therefore, the work done is non-zero value. Now, as a matter of illustration of this cyclic process, I have shown a curve which shows the variation of pressure with volume. So, a sample of gas has been taken from A to B, then to C, then to D, then to A. So, it has been brought to A from A itself. Then it is of a cyclic process. Now we shall have to find how much is the amount of work done while I have taken this gas system of gas from A to B, then C, then to D, again to A. So I can identify this by drawing a line. The path carried by this thermodynamical process possesses a rectangle as well as a triangle. While I draw a line like this, A, E, C, D is a rectangle. Therefore, the area under this A, E, C, D, A, that has been given as the amount of work done. So, it is a rectangle. So, length into breadth. So, change in length. So, length is 200 minus 100. Change in breadth 2 minus 1. Therefore, the rectangle gives an amount of work done of 100 joule. And I can see this E, B, C as a triangle. So area of a triangle is half into B into H. So work done by this E during this E, B, C equal to half into breadth B 3 minus 2, height 200 minus 1. Therefore I get 50 joule. Therefore the total amount of work done is 100 plus 50, that is 150 joule. This is the way we have to calculate the amount of work done using a cyclic process. Now, the first law of thermodynamics is consistent with all natural phenomena. But naturally occurring phenomena, it is not being allowed by another law, that is what is called as second law of thermodynamics. So So this second law of thermodynamics does not allow the natural phenomena that is being consistent with this first law of thermodynamics. This second law of thermodynamics introduces a quantity that is what is called as entropy. So as to find out the change of the system, we make a formula del S equal to many of the phenomena that is consistent with this first law of thermodynamics is not being allowed by the second law of thermodynamics. Suppose I have a table which is hot enough. Let me place a book over this. As a result, definitely heat has been transferred from the hot table to the book. As a result, the book gained some energy. But the energy possessed by this book, it's not being exhibited because the book still is on the table. On acquiring the energy, it does not rise itself. Therefore, some of the natural phenomena, it is being considered with the first law of thermodynamics, however, not being allowed by the second law of thermodynamics. The second law of thermodynamics introduces a concept that is what is called as entropy. So what is entropy? Entropy is the measure of disorder of a system. So it is given by delta S equal to delta Q by T. So it's a very important formula. People look for some problems regarding this change of entropy. Suppose I am provided with 0.1 kilogram of ice. So it is being converted at 0 degree Celsius into water. Let us assume that the latent heat of fusion is given as this much of value. I can find out this change in entropy using this. Now, suppose I have a heat engine. A heat engine works between a hot reservoir and a cold reservoir. Let me have a hot reservoir at a temperature T1 and a cold reservoir at temperature T2. A heat engine absorbs Q1 amount of energy from the source, which is maintained at a temperature of T1, and thus some amount of power, and it rejects a particular amount of heat, that is Q2, to the sink, which is maintained at a temperature of T2. During its working, as to have the engine to maximum efficiency, Carnot has given us a formula, that is eta equal to W by Q1, where W is called as the amount of work done, which is given by Q1 minus Q2. Q1 is the amount of heat that has been taken from the source, and Q2 is the amount of heat that has been rejected to the sink. So the amount of work done is given by Q1 minus Q2. That is Q1 minus Q2 by Q1, where Q1 is the amount of heat that has been extracted from a source at a temperature T1. Q2 is the amount of heat that has been rejected to a sink at a temperature T2. Therefore, the amount of work done is given by Q1 minus Q2. The eta can be written as 1 minus Q2 by Q1. It can be easily shown as Q2 by Q1 equal to T2 minus T1. Therefore, the expression for efficiency can be written as eta equal to 1 minus T2 by T1. As to find out this efficiency of a heat engine, here I have introduced a problem. So, the source is at a temperature of 127 degrees Celsius and the sink is at a temperature of 27 degrees Celsius. The amount of heat energy that has been extracted from the source is 40 kilojoules. Now we have to find how much is the amount of work that has been done. For this, we know the value of T1 and T2. On expressing in Kelvin, we can write eta equal to 1 minus 300 by 400. So eta equal to 1 by 4. We have another formula for eta as eta equal to W by Q. So eta equal to W by Q, making a substitution for Q and eta, I get the value of W as 10 kilojoule. Now we have another engine which has the reverse operation as that of the Carnot engine, which is called as a refrigerator. In the place of efficiency, we spell the word which is called as coefficient of performance, which is given by beta. So eta is given by W by Q. Here beta equal to Q2 by W. Q2 is the amount of heat energy that has been extracted from the cold substance, and Q1 is the amount of heat that has been expelled to the surrounding. Q1 Q2 is the amount of heat energy that has been extracted from the cold body, and Q1 is the amount of heat energy supplied to the body. Therefore, the amount of work done can be calculated by the formula Q1 minus Q2. So, which is given by beta equal to T2 by T1 minus T2. In this video, I have shown a simple way of calculating this work done associated with the thermodynamical process. I hope that you can enjoy those in learning this thermodynamical process in a great way. Thank you.